Alright guys, welcome back. We're gonna just pretend that last episode didn't happen. Because it destroyed us. It utterly destroyed us, dear lord. Commander, after recent success, members of the Resistance in West Asia have brought us support. Reports of activity that we may want to investigate. And that is a chance for intel. There's currently no second base here, because that's been retconned, but I get the feeling we'll get the same amount of extra from the same timer. Let's not spend time going down to the radio relay quite yet. I do want to go get that built. But, let's see, we're currently located... Wait, where are we located? We're over here, right? Because the... There we are. I was blending in with the mountains in my head, somehow not spotting that. So we have alloys here, intel... I feel like grabbing the intel is a reasonable thing to do here. Rather than go all the way down there right now. So I'm gonna do that. I remember last time when I went down there, I kind of regretted it just because it took so long to fly that far south. I'll be there soon, because it's one of my goals, but this thing popping up, might as well grab it while I'm nearby. Alright, so we just finished the spider suit research. Dark event. Intel costs are doubled. The one we did not prevent. All the more reason to try to get more intel here. Are they doubling you up this time?
Commander, the aliens are still moving forward on the Avatar project. Taking out that facility would deal a serious blow to their efforts.
Kind of a mess for me, because it kind of counter... Because I was already heading down here for this one, so the idea that this one's suddenly worth more for the enemy kind of messes with my whole progression here, because I was getting ready to take this one out. I could still take this one out first and go after that one next and let it stack up a little bit, but... I am very aware of the fact that there's only 4 points left until they win, and, that worries me. Because we haven't really struck back besides when we took out the black side at the beginning. Let's go ahead and finish this up real quick, because we just have a few days.
Incoming message for you, Commander. Patching it through to your quarters now.
Your progress against the aliens over the past month has been significant, Commander. But there is still room to improve if we are going to eliminate the alien threat.
Yeah, they're not happy about the Avatar progress for obvious reasons. Dun dun dun. Okay, so 3 objects, minor breakthrough, adding 1 block. Hey, it changed. It was 2 blocks last time. Once again, the faceless, which is low priority for me. They're not the most devastating problem to encounter, sometimes at least. And the aliens are on high alert, making it harder for XCOM to catch them unaware. Yeah, not great options in general, but avoiding the breakthrough is a pretty good priority. A supply drop is there, ready for us. One more day. There we go. And we've got a transmission. Let's take a look at it. Hidden Priest. Neutralized target for 181 supplies and 95 intel. That is a lot of intel.
Resource located.
Scorched Earth. 44 intel reward. The surrounding territory was pockmarked and burned with ribbons of unusual discoloration marring the landscape. Using the scanners, we managed to follow the ribbons' trails to a downed alien patrol craft. With no signs of life nearby, our team quickly recovered what they could. So that was the intel we got. And they're mentioning that we have a supply drop available, which will be a priority. Because supplies means we can buy our equipment, but for now, I'm going to go ahead and do the mission. In West Asia. It was called the Council mission, right? Yeah, there's the relay we want to finish. So much split attention, huh? Alright, let's do Hidden Priest.
Setting course for the West Asian
Just
corridor.
Like last episode, it's a very abrupt beginning, like practically at the beginning of the episode
fight. We'll need to have one of our troops equip the Skulljack for use in the field if we're going to make any progress towards our current objective.
So among other things, I'm going to edit Balls and give him that new armor. It's not here. No, spider suit, there we go. Oh hey, spider suit gives you 20 dodge, 1 mobility, that's nice. The armor mounts a grappling hook and cable on the left arm, permitting rapid elevation change and access to tactically advantageous positions. Very good. Bam.
The spider suit will improve our soldiers' chances of dodging an attack, while also providing increased agility and grappling capability.
Oh yeah. Gonna want one of those on all my snipers, and many of my characters, really. Some variation of suit that gives them extra powers, because that is the only way we turn the tables here. We need powers on our characters, because all the damn enemies have powers of their own. Did he have scars on his face when I first got him, or did he get those from getting the shot a lot? Because I'd buy either as an option. Alright, so our loadout here. We are specifically missing a ranger, so I'll probably want to swap out one of our multiple grenadiers for one. Ranger options. Zulu is wounded for one more day, of course. So that makes our only options Evo and Steven Smart, which are virtually identical at this point in the game. Alright, one ranger, two snipers, two grenadiers, one specialist. Decent setup. Let's make all utility items available so I can equip you with a med kit. There we go. And let's invest in our higher level characters with some special skills. Let's go into Harvillo. He's often in damageable range. Give him the combat sim for 19 dodge. There we go, making him harder to hit. I'm going to try to use sims on my higher level characters because they're less likely to suddenly die than the lower level ones are. They'll get their chance. But ideally, I'm going to want to collect more sims in the first place so I can use them again. It says it can be reused, but it also says sims. But yeah, I assume that means you can't use them. Yeah, you can't reuse them in general. It said sim, not stim, right? So like, sim made me think like it was some sort of, like, you know, the girl in the red dress simulation, like stuff like that. But I guess they're not repeatable, which is what it said and was to be expected. Any special items to equip? Nothing left. Who currently has a skulljack? Right, the melee guy does, which is bad because he's terrible at hacking. Sorry, I mixed up what the inventory was there. There we go. Remove the skulljack. We're going to give it to our specialist because they're better at hacking than anyone else in the party. And that's a big deal because I tried hacking somebody with a ranger in a previous mission and they had almost zero chance of success, whereas Wanderbot had basically 100% chance of success last time. Right now, Harvillo's the one with the armor. Let's take it off of him. He's not the one that needs the nanoscale out of this party. Let's put on the character that's most likely to go into melee range to help avoid them getting taken out abruptly. And I believe that is where I want to be with this, right? You've got your spider armor? Yeah. I'm going to want to build some more of those, but this will be our chance to test run that new technology. I get the feeling it'll be pretty useful. We'll see if this is a comparable... We'll see if this level turns out to be comparable to the last one or not. Like, is it going to be the same city setting? Because if it's big, tall buildings, the ability to grappling hook to the ceiling would probably help a lot.
For our help in dealing with a VIP said to be working in close collaboration with Advent forces in this region. It's likely the aliens will be providing security. We need to secure the AO and eliminate any hostile contacts nearby. Capture the VIP if possible. If not, take them down.
Alright, the VIP part seems very consistent, so I'm wondering if the VIP is specifically... if this mission's specifically scripted to happen when I do that one intel investigation. Makes sense, if you're gathering intel, that the event could be scripted to give you access to information about a VIP to take out. Let's see if I can avoid losing, 5 characters this time. Like, I'm okay with continuing.
Target location confirmed. Move to engage. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
Like, if I complete a mission and I'm successful, but oh no, someone tragically died or got captured, I would continue forward, because it's an acceptable part of the game.
Escort concealment.
But when I'm obliterated, I just see Murphy's Law coming back. Like, that sequence of episodes where my entire series fell apart, and I'm like, I can't do it again, man. So our objective is here. Our extract point is there. Now that's interesting, because it means that the entire thing we're doing... we're going down one street that goes around a relatively large building. If I can hop on that roof, we could get a lot done, potentially. Let's see. Move forward first with our tankier characters. We'll have Wanderbot wander over there. Oh, I guess I could just click on him. There we go. Alright, not entirely psyched with this movement range. I wish I could hop behind one of these, because I feel like this is the priority direction to hide towards, but, let's let you scout a little bit. Nothing spotted so far. Okay. Let's pop forward with a ranger.
Headed there now. Got a group of hostiles over here.
And we immediately have spotted targets. Okay. Well, they're gonna see us as we approach our target, and we pretty much have to go there, so going all out right off the bat probably doesn't ultimately hurt. It's probably the thing to do. The main concern I have right now is, of course, that my snipers would be best served being behind cover, rather than opening fire from here. So I'm gonna spend one turn setting up an ambush, I think, and moving our characters as close as I can without getting in trouble. Oh, the humans. Pesky, pesky humans. Learning to not like them very much, huh?
Copy that.
Let's head forward, balls. Stay behind cover and no one will see us. Hopefully those humans don't do too much patrolling. Hopefully they stay put for the moment, is what I'm hoping. Those guys aren't going to be moving any closer, so I think I can get away with sneaking up over here. Just one turn is set up, and then we can make a mess, hopefully. See, who can still move? The ranger can still move too, right? Yeah. Not great, though. But okay. Let's have him sneak a little further forward, because then he could potentially be in melee range for somebody. Wanderbot can go further forward, but this, yeah, all the covers, all his options aren't really cover, except for maybe that one. It could be a starting point. Might move further forward with him afterwards. Not spotting anyone new over here? Good. We spotting someone new? Oh, it's a tower, that's why. Alright. Two main enemies. We have one heavy back here. Still looking for a place to move to. We take this route, we're still behind cover, and we're not crossing his squares. So it should be a safe approach. And this should more or less set us up to ruin them at the beginning of our next turn. Unless they detect us right now. Oh, he's walking real close right now. I heard a door open. Alright, no one spotted us apparently. You can feel it closing in though, can't you? Hey, pigeon. Just hanging out, bobbing your head like crazy. So, oh yeah, he's probably in this room specifically. Yeah. He's gonna be inside. So I probably just want to blow my way through the building, really. And fire on anything that shows up. That can be a good thing. Being on an interior setting can give me an advantage at times. So one is right here. One is right there. Fantastic chance of hitting across the board. Alright. There's my grappling hook, which is always good news. Alright, set up our kill zone to ruin these guys. They know what they did. Wait, can I... Did he still have an action? Wow, he's got a kill zone set up, but... Oh, no, that's Harvillo. They're standing so close to each other that I thought the camera was overlapped. I thought it was the same camera position. So they have, it looks like I'm gonna get spotted this next turn, basically, if I don't move. Because I set the kill zone, then it cut to this guy, and it felt like the camera barely moved. I thought he was able to do his lightning hands afterwards for a second there. I'm like, that's insane. I never expected you to have that power. Oh man, how tempting is it? Just grenade that corner of the building, collapse the building to give us a nice clear entrance point, maybe even spot new enemies in the meantime, and also make some noise. Before Overwatch, you do, I can move closer. There we go. You can still get closer before we start. Wanderbot on Overwatch. Another sniper in Overwatch. No. What I'm kind of hoping will happen is I'm kind of hoping that these guys get wiped out by the Overwatch and maybe someone's still in Overwatch after the explosion and maybe an enemy comes charging out and gets shot by them afterwards. That would be quite ideal. He has three grenades, so I'll probably go with him. So let's have you go into Overwatch. It's really satisfying to be this close to them, actually, and have them not have seen me yet. Let's see. Overwatch. No one's left. Good. Let's make a fun mess. Grenades are like my favorite part of this game. It's just fun. Partly because of the environmental damage.
This is for you.
Howdy, folks. This is for that thing that happened in the alternate universe last episode that is no longer canon. Infinite Crisis. That's a whole big chunk of wall gone. You guys better run to cover. Oh no. We're gonna try to intimidate you as bullets penetrate our brains. We're gonna get you. Oh wait, crap, we're screwed. Killzone's great, right? Yeah, Killzone's great.
Kill confirmed. That is not good.
You gonna hit him again now? There you go. These slow motion sequences are really awkwardly choreographed. There's so many awkward pauses. Like, oh, something's freaking out again. Like, it's satisfying because, you know, just because you get the feeling of, I did it. But it's awkward in that there's so many moments of awkwardly staring at a guy doing nothing. Like, they didn't figure out how to time the sequences very well. Holy crap. What? All right, there's two snakes over there. I don't know how I see them. Can I see them? I don't think I even can see them. I think that's... Maybe. Let's click on you. I don't... You could conceivably almost have line of sight of that. Anyway, this looks like a big open room. So... Getting ready. How do I want to approach this one? Is that a top window I could fire through? That does look like a window I could fire through. Huh. I'm gonna want to step forward with these characters. He can take full cover by this wall.
Okay.
Let's see what happens. Are we spotting new people immediately? Not immediately. Alright, let's learn about your grappling hook. You can just shoot right up to that wall? Let's try that out.
Grapple out!
Is that a full action? Is that a full turn, or can you do another action afterwards? Because that's a pretty big move just from the get-go. Oh wow, he still has two actions after that. So every three turns, he can just go shooting across the map. I need more of those. It's not even just an elevation difference. The big thing was that I did like a full sprint of distance coverage with one action. And that in itself is pretty big. Alright. I think we want to charge forward with this other sniper because he's so far back right now. Preferably in a position where he can spot people, like through this... Yeah, like right there would give him a line of sight through the building. Hello, Top Notch. We'll get to you in a moment. Oh yeah, that's a direct path right there. That seems doable in 10 turns, right? Go straight through the middle of this room. To go through this giant open lobby. Grab the VIP hanging out in this room. Go to the street. Way more straightforward of a path than we got last episode, at least. There's a bit of... You can get a bit of a different condition based on the randomization of the environment each mission. That's full cover. I think ultimately this guy, where is he? There we go. I think Rocket's ultimately going to stay put right here in Overwatch. Because I think other characters are going to end up walking further than they otherwise would need to. I think I'm going to sprint with certain characters just so they can get to cover this turn instead of being stuck in the back. You're the most left, right? Yeah. So you're probably gonna take this left cover.
No need to ask twice.
Fuck up that door. Oh, there's a mutant too. Alright. None of that triggered an Overwatch, huh? Do I not have line of sight at all in that direction? Really thought I would, actually. Anyway. There's some fun to be had with this. So you still have an action. I can pop a grenade down there. That could be fun. What kind of angles do I get? Ooh, I can actually get that guy from here. Alternatively, I can get snakes. Not both at once, though. Can I get both these sources of cover at once? That'd be fun. Nope, that's not how the tiles work. All right. Let's get the perfect position to blow up the Mutant, because he's a problem. Come on, I had it. Come on. Stay perfectly still now.
Catch.
There we go. Lulz. Now his armor is shredded, and he's lower on health. Which is just how we want it to be, because those guys are the worst. Did not trigger Overwatch somehow, which is kind of a bummer. So how far can I make it in one turn? Clearly not far enough, right? Yeah, because of how this character works. Let's see. And I can't even get behind cover very well. I may want to stop back a little bit. Snakes do kind of ruin everything, don't they? Let's get over here.
Location confirmed.
Spread out our targets a little bit. I'm hoping that as they attack, they have to... I'm hoping they'll reveal themselves to the other character, but they may never be able to attack him. Here we go.
Already there.
I really thought that my Grenadier would have better Overwatch than that in this situation, but I guess it must be a maximum range problem. It must be too far away. Maybe now that'll trigger, though. Wait, what did he just do? Oh. Uh-oh. Oh.
Taking fire over here!
Could have gone worse. Oh, there's the inevitable. Oh, they targeted the guy. I was kind of hoping to use his sword actually when they grabbed somebody else. There's what I was hoping for. And it's grazed. Why, game? Why must you? Ah.
Took some damage here.
Snakes, why? Well, we have two snipers now, which is the intended result here. Hopefully, two snipers that can shoot both of those snakes. Is that their whole turn? Good. Okay. What is this tab doing right now? No, yeah, go to the outside sniper. Where is he? There we go. Lightning hands. 78. 47. We'll focus on the one that's in here because he's under the roof, so he can't be targeted by our other friend. Oh no. 70. Wow. It's just like last episode where a 78% chance of success still fails, and like, how are you doing this to me, man? That's so improbable. Come on. Take him out. Are you gonna...
Looks like you're coming with us.
Are you gonna shoot?
Target identity confirmed.
What?
Menace 1-5.
Remember, oh, we saw the VIP. I was like, what is the game loading right now? Why aren't I shooting? Yeah, the subdue thing. I hit shoot and then we just stared at him for 10 seconds and nothing happened and I wasn't sure what was going to go there. Alright, that's one snake down. If I use the other snake to take out the other enemy, promotion earned. We'll use other sniper to try to take out the other snake. And then that ranger could do a lot of damage really quickly. 100% chance. I like that number. You can't RNG me to death with that one. They probably can. 100% chance. No, I'm not trying to kill the VIP. I'm trying to actually be successful this time. 77%. Come on. Oh, he's hanging in there, huh? Still, there's other people that could be used against that. I think the best use of the Ranger is going to be to stab the Muton, because they are the worst in every capacity. And I'll try to attack them so I'm hanging out in this doorway in case somebody else pops outside. Come on! There we go, and we get loot. That's all good news. Alright, this is going well so far, which means something terrible is going to happen very soon.
I'm sure the docs will want to see this.
I can target them from here? Not the best hit chance, but we can at least approach to fix that. Somebody else can probably take the shot and be successful anyway. 57, but you can flank him. Oh yeah, that's a complete flank.
No problem, boss.
A nasty surprise would be finding out that one of these humans is a faceless. But actually, I don't think that thing's active right now. 83, so naturally it's gonna miss. Nope! Oh yeah, that's full damage. The power of flanking.
Well, how about that?
Cool. How are we doing on health? You lost two, you lost two. They're both doing relatively okay. I don't necessarily need to heal yet, because the heal is for 4, and I may want to save it a little longer than that. Let's go charging forward and make up our lost ground. Who's left? Just Wander? Yeah. Alright. Wanderbot, you're full on ammo. So I'm gonna have you do is a yeah, we'll go up to the wall.
Closing on target position now.
To reduce number of directions you can be attacked from. But then we're going to enter Overwatch. In case someone comes sneaking in.
Be advised, hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position. Firebrand has a limited window to provide extraction.
Alright, I think I want to move this character somewhere else. Maybe even up here next. Oh, the elevator's all the way... That's a far ladder. Okay. I'm going to sneak around the corner here. You know what? I'll save him for last. My plan is to go over here, hang out this corner and reload, and start heading this way so I can continue to cover my allies while still having the line of sight advantage. But, I think before we do that, let's see, I should get you up there too. I'm gonna get my other sniper up there.
Got it, moving.
What's handy about keeping them outside is that they can be on Overwatch. I can specifically set them on Overwatch if the enemy reinforcements start showing up somewhere over here or somewhere over here. Once that flare goes down, I can wipe them all out. But let's focus on the people inside first. Just in case I have something to respond to all of a sudden, I can do that. Their ultimate goal is to go over there. We can have rocket approach. See if he spots someone. No one yet. Alright. Let's have you open the door. Hello? We see you. Oh. Is it just you? Is that why it's saying combat? What's triggering this combat alert right now? Here, I'll head inside the room. Do I see anyone? I think it's just saying that guy's a combat character. Huh. Well, we're not quite in range yet, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to enter the room and I'm going to put people into Overwatch so that if anyone ambushes us while we're getting ready to subdue him, then we can take them out.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Alright, fireball. I'm going to have you sprint because you're really far away. So you have ground to cover. There we go. Maybe same with Rocket, too. Just get him on the door, too. That door's closed. Let's see, I don't think this leads anywhere. Necessarily, so the best cover position would be to stop at this door here.
I guess that'll be okay.
Alright, the two people in the room are covering. Well, he's about to be covering. Alright, we'll see if anyone comes in. You're the last action, so you're gonna pop to the corner, like planned. We'll see if he suddenly spot anyone on the roof over here. Doesn't seem to be. Alright, reload. There it is. Alright. Any enemies coming at us? Oh. Who did I shoot? What is that? I didn't get a good line of looks like a soldier. Oh, that's a whole pod. Is that why we were dramatic musicking? Alright, line of sight's bad right now. We have two grenadiers that can make a big mess of things. And that's just my favorite thing, so of course I'm going to. Just be really careful. Yeah, shouldn't hurt any of my guys. And it's fun. It's pretty much my entire thought process there. Get him, Pink. Yeah. And the VIP is only sort of singed. Good job, VIP, being kind of singed. What kind of enemies do we have out there? So my two snipers are in a bad position right now because they can only pistol. But I might as well try to pistol. Oh, I can't even get behind cover. Well, I don't want to not be behind cover, so let's go behind cover.
Seems doable.
And if I can't pistol them, I'll try to... Yeah, I can't pistol them. Let's just throw a grenade then. That'll be fun. There's gotta be something that... Yeah. That'll make you worthwhile. Here, I got you the thing that you can do this turn. Yay! A round that has ended with leftover grenades is a failed round. I wonder if I can get on the roof. Oh yeah, I can grappling. Ooh, how's that for a line of sight change? Without using any AP, I could actually snipe this turn. Oh, that is. I am thankful for this. Two advanced troopers right there. Or kill zone. Enhanced squad sight overwatch in cone of fire if they make the mistake of moving at all. Now that's really tempting too. We have three shots to spend. That could be really effective at taking out the enemies here. Giving it a shot. No, not him. 68% chance of killing the Muton. I could also move in there. Let's see. I could move up, which increases my chances significantly. We also have this guy here. Yeah, just that guy. Let's see here. You could actually try to go up and stab somebody. Can't reach that guy, but you can reach this guy. Which is a decent chance of success. Minus the potential flanking. Alright, let's be aggressive then.
Position confirmed.
Inching forward with Wander. So we can shoot this guy. No. That guy in the face. Hello, friend. And goodbye, face. Yay.
Hostile neutralized.
The best part's when they fall over.
Alright. And I'm hoping the Overwatch will pan out, but either way, let's be aggressive. Let me scroll. What are you doing, mouse?
If you say so.
It has some fascinating interpretations of where it thinks your mouse is sometimes, where it's just like, no, we're going over here next, right? Not him. 40% chance of success. Tempting. What I'm really tempted by is this, though. If I fire a grenade down there, then he won't be in cover, which means he's probably going to run around like a lunatic to try to get in cover, which means he's probably going to get murdered by balls. So first, I'm going to go for the sword attack. And then if the sword attack's unsuccessful, I'm going to try to shoot that guy instead. But I'm hoping the sword attack will work out. Go, go, gadget, stabby stab. That's exactly what happened. And is the Grenadier the only person left now?
Got him.
Let's see. Yep, he's the last one. Alright. So yeah, I want to scare this guy out.
Frag out!
Because when he has no cover, they usually go for cover if they have cover. They don't like to stand in the open. And while he's running around, his remaining hit points will get wiped out by the sniper, hopefully. We'll see. And we'll see if a surprise ambush shows up too, to ruin everything. Dun dun dun! Hello, friend. So Balls is just getting scary at this point, right? With all the skills he has. This is why it's so great to get upgraded characters, they have so many tricks. That the combination of grappling hook and kill zone is just crazy. Alright, next up is to subdue. I'll make that the Ranger's job. The Ranger's too far away. It'll be the specialist job. Where is he? There we go. I need to stop using tab so much, it just makes this thing a mess.
Confirmed.
Alright, you run up to this guy, and now you subdue him. You're mine now, thank you.
Status confirmed. Target package in custody.
K.O. Alright, evac, lightning hands, kill zone, grapple. Oh, you can't pick him up yet because he used the turn? That's annoying. Alright, I should probably use fireball or something then. That's annoying that took a whole action.
I can handle that.
I haven't had to pick up bodies for a while. Let's have you carry him. I just want to use as few actions as possible while we try to make our way to the evac point and in what time we have left. Let's get you behind cover.
I'm going.
Oh, there's a hole in the wall. That's great. We had fun here. Grenades are fun. Just don't tell your kids that. Let's make our way to the actual evac point. Please don't be camping the evac point, assholes. Please. Here. Wow, you can cover some ground. Alright. Keep our sniper on the roof, just in case. There goes Balls. Here goes our other friend.
No need to ask twice.
Didn't get much roof action, but he was helpful. I think he was. Yeah. Oh yeah. He got his promotion because he got a chance to snipe a snake. So he was definitely useful for the survivability of our squad.
Move.
Now we just need to make our way to the extraction and hope we don't get ambushed.
Uh-oh.
This
1-5, we're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position.
Well, we could secure a really nice, we could secure a really, really nice amount of promotions if we could do some sufficient, overwatch with that guy to just be prepared for wiping him out. Yeah, I think I'm gonna try to go for that. We're close to the extract, so it shouldn't be too big of a problem at this point. It's pretty far away still, though. Alright. Have you Overwatch? Wanderbot's still pretty far back. Let's have you camp behind the wanted poster.
Moving on target.
Then Overwatch. You have squad sight, so definitely Overwatch. Fireball's gonna come up behind this.
No problem, boss.
Come up behind here. Can you drop a body and then Overwatch? You picked up a body and then moved, so I assume you can get away with putting him down and do an action, I hope. Please. Please. Fuck, his turn ended. Well, that was a waste. Still little quirks to figure out. Alright, Wanderbot won't be in range to Overwatch, really, so what I'm gonna do is just charge forward as fast as I can. So that he can help with the... help clear out the remainders. That's the fastest route, is to climb on the roof? Interesting. Isn't there a hole in the wall over there? That's fine. And then, yeah, you could... they probably won't be in range right away, but if they run towards us, it'll help. We can't reach it. We can't reach the extract in time anyway, so we might as well try to wipe them all out. I could extract a few people, then, but we'd just be dooming. We'd just be getting other characters in trouble at that point. Come on, this has been such a clean mission.
I've got eyes on adventure.
Give me the. Just let this part go well. All right. Pshoom. That guy got behind cover immediately, so no one overwatched on them. Oh no.
Missed. Adjusting aim.
Wow. Completely unsuccessful. Really, even squad sight didn't have an Overwatch perspective there. Wait, but I... what? Weird. I can see all three of them from here, so how did I not trigger Overwatch if they're all within my line of sight? That's really strange. Well, free shot. We'll start with that one. Just on you? Right. Pistol range. Yeah, we'll start off with what I can do with these characters. That was the free shot. We'll also get yours. You can't get yours off. Out of range. Okay. Who can you see from here? All of them too. Okay. Let's go. Let's do the cycle and see who still has grenades. Because with the proper grenade usage, we could wipe out any elements of cover they have right now. And Evo can go stab somebody in the back, which is fun. Like this guy over here. Can you stab him? You can't. He's out of range. Okay. It's letting me stab over here. How about over here? There we go. I'm gonna start with the stab. Come on. The humans are running around during my turn. That was a scream. Alright, one down.
Hostile neutralized.
Two to go. That narrows down our people to follow up on. Frag grenade range isn't quite doing it yet, so we're gonna want to move forward, which we can do. Wanderbot's kind of in the way. Wanderbot does not have grenades. He has skull mine, but that's not gonna come up here. I don't think I can reach him in a reasonable capacity to try to do something like that. So instead, let's flank. So I can flank this guy to try to finish him off.
Designated position.
Hey, buddy, old pal. That cover's looking a little less good from here, I think. 65% chance of success. Going for it. Got him. Two down.
Target eliminated.
Last target. And he's the tough one because he's really far away. But I think I have two snipers who have some chance of hitting him. And if I could get close enough to fire a grenade, then we really are going to be able to get him. I might even risk standing in the open. No, let's not go too far. Alright, one step forward. Launch frag grenade. There we go, that'll be fun.
Yeah, catch.
Hey, buddy, old pal. And we'll still have like three turns left to get into with the extraction point. Which should be more than we actually need. Alright, three damage. And he's hurt. Cover's not destroyed because cars don't just die like that, but it's getting there. Let's start with balls, because he's closer. Ooh, grappling hook's ready. There's no distant position over there for me to grapple onto. It's just back here, though. So it's not going to have any fun tricks. It's just fun to acknowledge that it exists, I guess. 62% chance of success. That's the higher of the numbers. And we nailed it. And he does death from above, so I think he still gets an action, doesn't he? So he gets to still go towards the extraction point? He sure does.
Moving.
Go, go, go. He jumped through the hologram. Let's see. I'll stop at cover of some kind, just in case. But I don't think that... If we see any enemies, we don't know direction they'll be from. But we probably are all out of them anyway, honestly. Let's have you pick up the body again, and just get him extracted. It's actually comical how much cleaner this attempt went than the previous episode. Although I'm sure that it helps that there was no... We didn't data mine anybody. Most of the squad should be able to make it into the extraction zone all at once. But because some of them won't be able to extract till next turn, I don't want to actually extract. Oh, right. Never mind. This is the end of the turn anyway. I'll let you take the objective.
VIP secure and in position.
So we don't get in trouble there. And then next turn, pretty much everybody should be in range to try to get out of here.
Interceptors are on high-speed approach. Your window for extraction is closing.
Honestly, she was hiding behind an burning car. At some point, it's her own responsibility to not die in that situation. Alright. Let's have you run over here, but I believe that's the end of your turn, so you can't extract. Oh, wait, do you still get to extract? You do. Okay, you do. Then we're clear. Everyone gets their chance now.
Whatever you say.
Oh, cool. You can actually change characters while you're waiting for them to do their actions.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Heading home. Just in time.
Oopsie. Wrong one.
Evac confirmed.
That's really handy that you can just cycle through them all really quickly instead of waiting for the animation to play out. And we're out. Clean escape. Only two soldiers wounded, and those soldiers were only wounded by 2 points from... And not even... They weren't gunshots or anything. They got snake grabbed. Two really effective Overwatch... an effective Overwatch ambush, a few really good grenades to wipe things out. Really good use of the... I think I used the Ranger pretty well this time in particular, because the Ranger was taking out key units that simplified the rest of the process for us. Never had to heal. Balls had a lot of fun to play with this new toys. Successful mission. Even with the VIP extract, as opposed to accidentally shooting him in the face like last time. In my defense, the game was constantly saying to target him first. It really bugs me when there's a specific character that the player probably doesn't want to shoot, and every time you hit the shoot button, it's like, you want to shoot this character? These loading screens are somehow getting longer each time. Holy shit, 100% shot success. Wait, how is that possible? That doesn't actually make sense, because I had a... Maybe I'm misremembering. I could have sworn that I did a 78% chance shot that failed, and I was talking about that earlier. That percentage might be lying to me. I don't appreciate that. Well, we'll get a lot of supplies from that, which is really, really good. And then we have a supply drop over in the corner. So we have a lot of supplies coming our way, so... Spider suits for all the snipers. Unfortunately, our Ranger and our Specialist are both wounded. One much more than... Why are you gravely wounded, but he's just wounded? You both took the same amount of damage. You both got grappled. Oh well. A revival protocol and bring somebody back that's stunned. Or haywire protocol. Target a robot and mechanical enemies to and try to seize control. They're both pretty situational. Honestly, I like thinking of the specialists as being support characters, so I think I really do like the idea of sticking with revival again. Because being able to bring somebody back up when they get stunned is really good. Like, it's kind of amazing. Like, oh no, he's gone. He's going to be out for the rest of the mission. Psych, he's standing up again. And, like, just shrug off that crippling moment is great. But yeah, being able to seize control of a robot would be great, because they're dangerous, and turning them against the enemy would also be very effective. But, it's very situational, because we can have entire missions with no robots, but I feel like almost every mission has a stun lancer somewhere. And that might change. As we continue through the game, robots could be more common while stun lancers become less common or something. Let's see. When concealed, gain bonus to aim and crit chance when attacking enemies. Just make them really good at ambushing people. Okay. But Shadow Step's fantastic, because it means that people don't shoot back at him. They're both really good. The problem with the conceal thing is it only happens once, unless you specifically get skills that help him stay in stealth. I think I'm going to go with Shadow Step again. Frankly, it's just one of my favorite skills that class had in the previous XCOM. Alright, Death from Above or Quick Draw. Firing your pistol with your first action no longer ends your turn, which is handy. Because multiple potential shots could be a big deal. Just shooting everywhere all the time. He is continually being... Because... Oh, I mixed up my characters. He doesn't have Long Watch. Don't know why I thought he did. Anyway, I think I'm gonna go with Quick Draw for this character and continue his trend of becoming a pistol man. Got another core, and William Anderson is captured and looks oddly like that one dope. No, never mind. No, his...
Hello,
sorry.
Hello, Commander.
Got distracted by the silly hair, but his face looks nothing like anybody that I was thinking of. That's almost 200 supplies. That is fantastic. Alright guys, thanks for watching like always. That clearly went better than last time. I'll see you next time.